College nowadays is wild. Niggas purposely going into debt. The shit that they, you ain't got no business going to
do. Listen, man. Mind your business, okay? Goddamn. Leave me alone. Nigga, I didn't know I was breaking into a burning house. Nobody told me. The fire alarm wasn't on. I didn't see no lights, nigga.
It's America. Of course it was burning.
Oh, nah, bitch.
Yo.
Right.
Smells good.
Hey, man.
Chicken again?
So you know what I do all my life?
Bro, it don't even just be white people. It's just the white people. Smells good. Sorry to interrupt your lunch.
I've learned. No, I'm just saying what I do. All my white friends, I look at the things that they love to do, and I think it's
I'm sure Kendrick is not intentionally making up. It's Future and Metro and all them niggas. Like,
it's just big me,
This shit is so fucking hard. What the fuck? I love this beat. It's hilarious because I don't hear not one drum throughout both albums. The drums go hard. Them niggas hard.
Drake Cole gonna make some goddamn drums.
No, oh my god, this guy in my building, right? I always meet the craziest characters in my building. Like, so I've seen him walking through with some guitars. And I'm like, oh, you play guitar? He's like, yeah. But you know how somebody's like trying to downplay it? Oh, I play a little guitar. So I like, every time I see him, I ask him another question because he tries to downplay it. So this time, this last time I see him, I was like, yeah, tell me more about the guitars. He's like, oh, I used to be in a band and I used to like do lessons at this school. It's like this fucking prestigious ass school that's known for music. I'm like, what band were you in? I gotta go. I'm like, nigga, who are you? No, really. But then it's like he lives a million lives. The old lady that I be talking to, she was like, yeah, he used to work for the State Department. And then like
I'm gonna be like Spider-Man, this bitch, you're gonna be like this, you're gonna be like this.
No, really. No, working as a concierge, I've had so much time to people watch. You can realize the levels that people are good at bullshitting. Like, some people are just so casual with it. Like, oh, yeah, no. And some people are like masters. Like, when I first started working there, right? Everybody used to be like, oh, yeah, it was such and such. The mayor lives here. What's the rule? So I'm like, out who the mayor is, right? So,
Young Tech Nine, what's popping, bruh?
In the midst of me working there, like, when I first started working there, like, I used to, like, keep this one older man. And I used to be like, this creepy old man, he always just, like, he never say nothing to nobody. He just kind of, like, mind his own business. And I'm like,
are you really Young Tech Nine, though?
So I'm like, you know, I'm not gonna say call him creepy, but I just like, you know, just like he, just looking at his demeanor, I was like, who's this guy? Like, he doesn't talk to nobody. He's just like, oh, he doesn't say much. We having a meeting. They're like, oh yeah. I talked to the guy one day, and he's just like, oh, what's your name? When you start working here, what you do? I'm like, Carmen. And somebody comes back and they were like, oh yeah, such and such the mayor. I'm like, who? I'm yet to meet the mayor. Who's the mayor? And they're like, you were just talking to him. I'm like, this black guy? Like, this black man? that I see every morning and tells me good morning? They're like, yeah, that's the mayor. I'm like, oh, well, shit. I told you about the lady that, like, I was telling her how much I like Nirvana and like some bands, and she was telling me about how she lived in Seattle with all these people and telling me her band stories about her, how her friends dated the guy from Soundgarden, and like, yeah, and like she used to babysit like down the street from, she used to live to a few houses down from the house where Kurt Cobain blew his head out. She's very much married, so I'm sure that was her way of downplaying it.
Oh, okay, what's up, Scrapper G? I'm gonna say, yeah, who the heck is Young Tech 9, man? I would've remembered that name. What's up, bro? What's poppin', bro? Long time no see. Meet Carmen, our new co-host. Alright. Y'all ready? Will, you sticking around for the first time? What you doing, man?
Oh, nah.
That's okay. It's probably upstairs.
All right.
Damn, it's already 10 o'clock.
I know. That's what I'm saying. We got to, yeah. Shake. That's what I'm saying. We started bad late.
I shall see what I can do.
Thank you.
All right, guys. All right, guys. So, we're here. Starting a little bit late, but. You know, it is what it is. It's a Monday night. Shout out to my brother, Scrapper G, in the building, now known as Young Tech Now. What's up, bro? You guys already know the program, man. If you guys want to get your records or anything you guys wanted to see or react to, don't forget to put it in the comments below. If you don't want to wait in line, you can always send us a super chat. Or you can send me a screenshot that you follow all of us on social. And then I'll get to your record right away. All right. So, before we get started, man, I got to start us off correctly, man. Where is my playlist at? This sounds crazy. Guys, it is a wild fucking ride. A wild ride, y'all. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I'm flabbergasted. And like everything that's going on right now.
Whoa. There's a lot going on in the music right now.
I swear to God, man. I'm happy and I'm sad at the same time. And I'm explaining.
It's a rap apocalypse.
Right, after the eclipse, niggas just started acting up, man. All right. This is the vibe I'm on right now. Let's get started. Oh my God. It hurts my heart that we're never gonna get music like this ever again. He end up in the, you know.
And this girl right here, well, that's what she knows. So I'm going through a phone, and she go to the bathroom, and her purse right there. I don't trust these.
Oh my.
But that's just a result of me paying attention to all these women that think like men with the same intentions. Talking strippers and models that try to gain attention. Even a couple of stars that I'm ashamed to mention. But we see a son of my only role models. Half of Jordan, my only role models. That's why I walk around with all this gold on. And every time I run into these, cause they want no problems. Buy sixes and chains and some bracelets and rings. All of the little accents that make me a king. I never hear the disses they try and point out to
me.
But it's whatever if somebody won't make it a thing.
Oh shit. He was talking like this in 2011.
Do anything to buy gifts for their daughters. Get some shake a brick in the press. And chef it like Mrs. Fields, they making the cookie stretch. I know it so well. I know the hustle so well. Stuff like I'm working overnight is right by the motel. Drug money, outfit, record clean. Spend it all on me and my fucking scene. Matching rollies for real. Matching rollers for real.
Oh my God, man.
We actually going for real. I'm really killing all the jiggy rapping. I'm going trigger happy just to see my n****s happy. Mixtape legend, underground kings. Looking for the right way to do the wrong things. With my new n****s that's living in Palm Springs. Young ass, lifelong dreams. They take the grace from the past and compare us. I wonder if they'd ever survive in this era. In a time where it's recreation, I pull all your skeletons out the closet like Halloween decorations. I know of all the things that I hear they be poking fun at. Never the Frodo, they know I run that. You all, I claim that. Whenever I change rap forever, the gang back together, yeah. Why am I remain that forever in the same place?
Now, he actually went kind of crazy on this.
Yeah, yeah, I'm like, damn.
Like, you got a couple of shit get off his chest, God. Drake, this is Drippy, man. Oh, my God. Oh, no, 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 no. I got, hold on, man. No. This too much.
Oh, my God.
It's too much. What are you talking about?
Bro. Put your lights
up. I fly for my niggas, dog. I ride for my niggas.
What, man?
Come on, bro.
Niggas tryna get at me.
Dog.
I ride for my niggas. Stay scheming,
bro.
Niggas tryna get at me.
It's over, guys. It's over. It's fucking over. Life's so short. Fuck it. I don't want to go to court. Fuck it.
Got a budget
for the lawyer, though. I'm on the run for the month.
I'm in the butt.
Pay 200 for it.
My little nigga stunning even got me paranoid. I'm getting money, that's a nitty nigga category. Double M, I got
G's out in California. Shout out to Kendrick.
I ride for my niggas.
Oh my God, we gotta get started, but oh. I feel like I can't even stop it at Drake's bar. That's kind of like last, right?
It bothers me when the gods get to acting like the bras. Guess every team doesn't come complete with niggas like ours. That's why I see no need to compete with niggas like y'all. I just asked.
We got a lot to get into today, man.
Don't be ducking like you never wanted nothing. It's feeling like rap changed. It was a time it was rugged.
Back when if a nigga reached, it was for the weapon. Nowadays, niggas reach just to sell they records. Yo. Buddy heavy though. Shit like that, you never know.
$1 million meetings in the portal lounge. Me and my man all over North, that's how I roll around. Shorty wanna tell me secrets
about a rap nigga.
I tell that bitch
it's more attractive when you hold it down.
Kobe about to lose
150 M's. Kobe my nigga, I hate it, had to be him.
Bitch, you wasn't with me.
Oh shit. Bitch, you wasn't with me shooting in the gym. This shit's so toxic. Oh my god, R.I.P. Kobe. You and pussy identical. We can't wait to run into you.
But let me get my mind off that.
Young rich motherfucker getting mind off rap with my niggas. Oh my god, dog. Nah, turn this shit off. I can't. We gotta have a concert in here if I keep going, man.
Oh my god.
Niggas trying to get at me. They is trying to get at you, Drake.
I swear to God.
I ain't gonna hold you.
I ain't gonna lie. They were preaching.
What do to make them niggas that mad?
We know.
Oh, I know.
I forgot to turn that fan on. Hold on, one more. I'm gonna just need to turn this fan off real quick.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Okay. Lil CC.
Lil CC, it's me.
Yeah.
Could you?
I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my.
Hey, yo. I'm in this motherfucker broken as hell, man. What the fuck going on?
Record scratches.
I swear to God, man. What the fuck?
Hey, could you, why
you... Oh, now you want me to get the mic.
I mean, since you up.
Now you want me to get the... What the fuck is going on? I see what's going on.
Oh. It's okay. Acapella. Stacy,
man. Get it, CC.
Thank you. Niggas trying to get at me.
Niggas in the lab, bear with me. I'm going to clean this shit up on the edit, though. All right.
Welcome back.
Glad to be back. All right, let me get the music back on.
Yeah. I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps wasn't facts, so they sat with the bars. I got two phones, one need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I could tell they ass apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big stacks coming out to save. I got Lil Max with me, he the wave. It's a big gap between us in the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, put my money in the grave. When I die, put my money in the grave. I really gotta put a couple niggas in a place. Really just left every nigga in a race. I really might tap
this nigga on my face.
Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to save hoes with a mask and a cave. Now I'm like, nah, love, I'm good, go away. Ain't about to die with no money, I done gave it. I was on top when that shit meant a lot. Still on top like I'm scared of the drop. Still on top when these niggas wanna swap. Niggas wanna swap like the sauce in a watch.
Nah.
Hello.
I swear to God. What are we talking about? What are we doing? This is the music that we're not gonna hear no more?
I'm getting so tired.
I ain't with this talk since I was 18.
Apologize if I say
anything I don't mean. Like, what's up with your best friend? We could all have some fun, believe me.
And what's up with these new niggas?
And why they think it all comes so easy?
Forget it while you here, boy.
Hey, you gonna flip that though?
Hang up on the
hoe. Hey, yo, yo. Yo, no, when you used to hang up the phone with the flat, yo.
Yo.
White cups and I got that drink. Could be purple or could be pink. Mix that shit. Mix that shit cause I'm on one. I said fuck it, I'm on one. Nah, we gotta get started. We gotta get started. I'm sorry. We actually gonna get started now. We gotta get to it. We gotta get to it, man. We got to get to it. Alright, guys, we are back. We are back. 3, 2, 1. Top Hill, episode 173.
Good Lord.
Yeah. Welcome to another episode of the Top Hill Podcast. This is your boy, Mr. Top Hill Pod, a.k.a. E-Money Boss. And who are you is?
It is I,
D-Carmen. Welcome back, D-Carmen, man. I'm going to keep giving Carmen a round of applause, man. Welcome, it's D-Carmen. Carmen, what up? What's popping? What's good? How you doing, Carmen?
I'm doing good, man. I was up on the internet.
You was on the internet.
And seeing this blasphemy over the weekend.
Yo, the internet was interneting, wasn't it?
Wasn't it?
I swear to God, man. Yo. You know, guys, we got a lot to get into today. We're going to talk about the future Metro Boomin, We Still Don't Trust You album. We're going to talk about the Drake response. We're going to talk about Rick Ross's surprise response. And where the hell is Kendrick Lamar? You know, and then we're going to get into some of you guys' reactions as well too. So yo, hang tight. You guys already know what the deal is. You guys want us to react to your songs or anything you guys want to show us, go ahead, pull up to the live every Monday night. Let us know what you guys want us to hear, and yeah, man, come party with us, have fun. We're going to be in here for a little bit, so let's get right into it. But before I get into it, Carmen, how was your week, man? Everything good with you? Everything good on your side? She got that purple drink going, so you good? You vibing? You good?
I'm vibing.
She fried.
I actually had a fantastic week and weekend last week.
That's what's up. You want to talk about it? Is it public? Is it safer online or no?
Yeah. Okay. I got a new car.
Hey, hold on. Wait. Hold up. New car alert. Oh. Okay.
My blessings just been pouring in, and I'm very grateful.
That's what's up.
You know, I'm naturally sarcastic about a lot of things, but I try to be grateful about the blessings as they pour in, and I'm very grateful. So
yeah,
I had a very fantastic week.
That's good. Whenever I talk to Carmen, she always has like a nice, positive energy, spirit, stuff like that. So I already know, like, if anything ever like goes wrong or stuff like that, I feel like it shit just gonna pop right back up for you because you give. You know what I mean? You give, you get. You know what I mean? You give, you get.
Oh, thank you. Likewise. You know what
I mean? Yeah, for sure. All right, guys. This week. Oh, by the way, I mean Money Boss. I think I already said that already. But anyway, we're here. We still don't trust you, man. If you guys don't know, Future and Metro Boomin has released their new project, their second project, just a few weeks after their first one.
Oh. That's how great my week was.
That's what I'm saying. It started off great.
My week was amazing.
Like, it was the vibe that I needed too. Oh my God.
I love when Future drops though. I'm not going to do like.
Future Vandross? When Future Vandross pop up? Yo.
Okay.
Yo.
First of all, when Future dropped right before the summer, like, you know.
Oh yeah.
Man, y'all better birth control up. Like, it's
bruh!
It's that season.
Oh my God, dog.
Megan already confirmed it's another hot girl summer and the bitch has been hot.
Hey yo. Like, hey yo. yo, karma's funny as shit. I'm gonna try to
Future
not
Ben Ross.
my intrusive thoughts almost went out. Oh my god, yo, I ain't gonna lie. Future and Metro Boomin delivered the project of the summer for sure, because the first project, that's the one that's gonna get you going, right? That's the joint that you're gonna play before you go to the club.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean?
Or yep.
And then, you know what I mean? It's the same joint you're gonna do when you're on your way to Shawty House, you know what I mean? Get your energy up, you know what I mean?
It's like after the club.
And then after the club,
we need to rush early.
Yo.
A couple bottomless mimosas.
I swear to God. And then you turn that "We Still Don't Trust You" on, and you start getting that little bop going, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Yo, I ain't gonna lie. This
"We Still Don't Trust You" is for when after the lady leave and you've got to pick
exactly.
up the ex. But it's yo. Cool.
Yo. Or when she sucked the soul out of you. You know what I mean?
Like, Lord.
Sorry, intrusive thoughts came out. I ain't gonna lie. I heard that album. It's so funny because I was on Twitter. I think you was on Twitter too. Like, the album was coming out. Nobody knew what was going on and stuff like that. I'm hearing this project. It's late at night. I'm like, yo, I'm about to take a drive. Like, this shit made me want to. Yo, what's up? You up? Like, yo.
Man, let me tell you. I had some company over.
Hey, yeah.
And I was all like,
talk about it.
We still don't trust you, but.
Hey, yeah. Hey, yo, hold up.
I said, what I do is drink your dance.
Yo, no, I ain't gonna lie. That joint is definitely a vibe. It's definitely a vibe. And I ain't gonna lie. Yo, it's tax season too. Lord. I talked to my tax lady. She's like, it's time for you to start having some kids. I'm like, God damn, man. Yo, it's hard out here, man. I swear to God, I'm about to turn Black Republican on y'all niggas. I ain't gonna hold you. Anyway, back. We Still Don't Trust You. Okay? Phenomenal album. This is the R&B side of what they got going on. Starting off, matter of fact, let me bring the track list up for you guys.
Geeking again.
Again. Should we start off with a little bit something? Hold up, man.
Oh my God, I love Future.
Yo.
So the fact that Future and Drake are out, I'm like, oh my God, you guys.
Can we all just get along? Can we just all J. Cole this thing out? You know what I mean? Oh my God. I'm gonna play a little bit something. I'm gonna play a vibe. I'm gonna play a song, and then Carmen, you tell me what song you wanna hear. We're gonna play a little snippet to both, okay? This is the one I wanna hear right
good
now.
Girls,
oh I my God. Yo. Nah, they went crazy on this one, man. Hear something, you good. You good. What you want to do? What you want to do?
We can do the outro. We got
to
get
through this. Okay. Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. I'm about over here vibing out.
We
just vibing out.
We
already
started 2 hours late.
Facts. All right. Yo, so this album came out. Really enjoyed it. Really is a vibe. Of course, everybody was assuming that this might be just a double down on the first project. I know I even was.
I had my suspicions because Future got a way with his words.
Yeah.
I feel like he always, like, whether it starts off, the album starts off turn, and then, like, he has, like, he gets back into his feels. Like, Future has his way of, like, getting his shit off both ways. It's like.
Right. And he gave us a lot of music the first one, too. Like, he felt like he got his rapping shit out.
He was like, here's a whole separate project just for the people and what they love. Like, I ain't gonna say what they love, but, like, I feel like Future definitely has two different fan bases. It's like people who strictly love Turned Up Future and people who love both sides of the coin.
Right.
He has a duality.
Yeah.
So.
And at the same time, too, like, this is, bruh, this R&B version, I ain't gonna lie, is like one of my favorite forms of Future. And if it's not broke, don't fix it. You know what I mean? Like, he did this before. He did the double project before where he did Future, and then he did Hendrix. It was the same kind of vibe that worked really well for him. Why not do it again? The game needs this kind of vibe right now. I'm gonna be honest with you. We got all the like trap, like street shit that we needed on the first one, and that shit is just getting better over time. It's aging like fine wine. Like That is still the number one song in the country, the third straight week in a row. Crazy. Bro, and he's going up against some heavy hitters. We forget, like, Beyonce just dropped. You know what I mean? Like,
and because I surely didn't listen to that.
I haven't got a chance to yet.
I like, only listened to Jolene, and I was like, all right. But I ain't going to speak on that. Beehive, don't attack me.
And shout out to y'all. Respect. You know what I mean? Just, you know what I mean? Respect. But, yeah, this is the vibe that I'm on. I had my ears open, you know what I mean, to see if we were going to get any disses and stuff like that. I like this Sunday. It's one of my favorite records on there as well, too. He did like a little subliminal diss on there, where he does the, you know, fill away. That's the reference joint that Drake did on Views. You know what I mean? So Future is pretty much saying like, yo, what you can do, I can do better. Every single thing that you do, you copy me. Like, I'm the vibe setter. You know what I mean? Like, I probably gave you a lot of sauce. So I think that's just the kind of shit that he was kind of get off. Same thing with the first record, the We Sit on Trusty record. He was doing that Honestly Never Mind kind of vibe, that dance house vibe, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And then The Weeknd, Able. After his hiatus, The Weeknd has been on doing like world arena tours, being a big, huge mega pop star. Literally went on and said, I'm not doing any more features. He said, I'm done doing features.
But I will do an exception.
He said, unless your name is Pluto or Metro.
I have this one exception for this one stick I have up my ass.
Cause not,
I have a quarrel with him.
A very big quarrel, because Future would, I mean, The Weeknd would not
do this with Future.
I'm sorry. The Weeknd would not be featured, not on one, not on two, but three.
That's very generous. That's very generous for Abel.
Yeah,
okay?
Very.
Very generous.
And he was featured on the first one as well, too. So this is four features from The Weeknd on these projects, which is actually insane. Of course, a lot of people are alluding that this is stemming from an XO versus OVO beef that they have going on. The Weeknd, in my opinion, gave the most direct shots and disses towards Drake on this project. Everybody else, well, we'll get to ASAP in a minute. But The Weeknd, I'm gonna bring up the bar for you guys. And Carmen, I don't know, did you catch this? Not Always Be My Fault. It was All to Myself. The Weeknd literally sang this Drake. Like,
I don't think I caught the bar. I just was like enjoying the melodic, and like, I felt like that was a lot of the stuff on the second project for me though, because I was just enjoying the album.
Vibe.
So I'm like, I know I'm gonna listen to this album long after this rap beef is over.
Right.
Because come on now, like, it was a great album.
Yeah. Nah, this is a phenomenal album. This is something, I'm going to be going back to. I'm literally going back and forth between the first and the second album now. So, all right. So, I'm gonna pull up the bar for you. All right. So, The Weeknd is on the second verse. These niggas always yapping, yeah. I promise that I got your back. Oh, look at how we moving, baby. This they could never diss my brothers, baby, when they got leaks in the operation. I thank God that I never signed my life away. Uh-oh. So, I don't know if you guys heard about leaks and Drake, but apparently some shit went down. I don't know. I heard that Drake was exposed, is what I heard.
Yeah.
I don't know anymore.
He's been exposed for a couple different things, so it's like.
No, like he was like naked, like nude, like.
Oh yeah, yeah. Completely. You didn't see that?
No.
What?
What the fuck?
That wasn't on your internet. That no, was on my internet. That's all.
No, no, literally. Okay, this. Like, okay, disclaimer.
The lady killer.
What the fuck? No, I literally just got back on Twitter this week. Like, what?
So
I don't know.
He has been under a rock. Oh, yeah, Drake. Yeah. It was definitely a video, but it was, like,
oh, shit,
not
nah.
disappointing. So.
Oh, what the fuck?
I mean, like, you know,
Oh, you don't gotta describe it or nothing like
that. It's
not that kind of show.
No, I'm not gonna describe it. I was just saying, like, it wasn't embarrassing.
Oh, shit.
Like, it definitely wasn't embarrassing. Like,
oh,
he probably was like,
God.
Okay. Like, if anything, like, his followers went up.
Bruh. This is crazy. Oh.
I'm just saying, like, okay, one for the light skins, like you.
Hey, young. All right.
In the first half, but.
Bruh.
You surprised me.
Oh, my God. Wow. Okay, so this is the bar that...
Matter of fact, everybody get leaked.
Hey, yo.
Leak Future. Leak your top three, and then I'm a judge.
Oh, my God. This shit almost scared me. I was looking at the annotation. I was like, oh, shit, don't bring up the Twitter here. But, okay, so that's what The Weeknd was alluding to on
the
leak.
Let the ladies judge.
And then, he says, I thank God I never signed my life away. You know, The Weeknd had the opportunity to possibly sign with Drake's OVO when they first were coming up. Mm-hmm. The Weeknd decided that he was going to stay independent, do his XO label, and that they would just be, you know, both two niggas from Canada. They'll be cool with each other, but I don't want to join
think
OVO.
Out like that, but, you know.
Yeah, I'm doing a nice
Man,
PR OVO version of it.
OVO XO Fest.
Yo, I ain't going to lie. The OVO XO...
Time
yo
was so like
that's another robbery.
You had to be there.
Yeah, you really
you had
did.
To be there.
Yo, like having that, like
OVO XO featuring Party Next Door, like man,
Jesus Christ. Yeah, no, nah, that was actually insane.
That was a time. Like I know so many kids that are in school right now just because like their parents was listening to
that. You know why you're here, right?
You know why you're here, right? Yo. Them niggas is beefing right now. You're a product.
You're a party, a product of Party Next Door, The Weeknd, and Drake. But yeah, you know, we were supposed to get like possible mixtape or albums with them together and stuff like that.
Bro, what the worst time to fall out? Like, we need to be coming together,
I
unity.
Yeah, J. Cole was right.
Like, bro, what type of alternate universe are we in that Beyonce is making country music? What is it called? Our Mount Rushmore of rappers are beefing. Artists.
And some of them getting cracks in the stones and stuff like that. J. Cole's face almost fell completely off.
He completely removed his own
right.
stone. He was like, I'm going to just get off.
He was like, let me get out of here.
Let me get off the mountain.
Oh, my God. And then, okay, and then the last bar here, he says, and they shooters making TikToks got us laughing in the Lambo. So,
who made a TikTok?
He was talking about Baka Not Nice.
Who?
Baka Not Nice, you know?
Who?
Oh, shit. You know Baka?
Who? My Snoop Dogg voice.
Bruh. Baka Not Nice is an OVO artist. He be with Drake. He's been locked up for, like, a minute. Like, it's alleged that he's, you know, done some...
Looks like a thumb.
Jesus Christ.
45. Hang it up.
Hey, yo. Let me see.
Baka is not nice.
Let me see if I can find one of these TikToks that Abel was talking about.
My intrusive thoughts are running.
it's already late, so I already know we on some bullshit. What the hell is this
Ew,
guy doing?
What the hell was he?
Oh, nah. Baka, what are you doing, bro? Yeah. Nah, Baka funny, man. All right, but yeah, so The Weeknd is referring to him laughing at that. So, Yeah. I like the record a lot. I love the sample. I think a lot. Metro did his thing with the production of this whole album. Like, to hear him do both sides, Metro's proven himself to be one of the best producers of this generation so far. So, this is gonna be quick. I don't even know if we want to talk about Rocky. Like, I don't even know if we want to dignify this nigga with so much of a response. But fuck it, here we are.
Let me get a go at him.
Yo, ASAP Rocky, man. Respectfully, my guy. Respectfully, my dude.
There's nothing memorable about that corner of the project.
Yeah, I was good off the mixtape, to be honest with you. But at the same time, you know, I'm hearing this.
I did not need the second half. I'm not going to lie, because it was dated. Like,
yeah.
I love Future. But it's like everything, he don't even rap like that no more. Like, everything on the second, like, half of it, or the second album is what they want to call it.
Yeah, it's called, they're calling it a mixtape.
Okay, the mixtape within the album.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't need that because that was like 2010 and beyond Future. Like, he don't even rap like that no more. He be like,
I'm glad you brought that up because I was thinking, like,
this doesn't even sound like him no more.
Yeah, something's a little off here. Like,
that was at the same damn time.
Right.
At the Future. That was him.
Because I was thinking, like, these tracks don't even sound like the last rap album. Like, no, they all sound different.
Like, they all sound old. Like, he's had them in the vault and he's like, if I don't get them out now, then I'm never going to drop this shit. Let's just see who fuck with it.
And I look at this as like he's, I felt like this was kind of like him trying to revive some of the rappers that are falling off type shit, or maybe on their way out, because you got Lil Baby on here too. Nobody really even talking about his verse. Like, Lil Baby, he's like kind of really forgotten. Like, yeah, you probably didn't even know.
They say Baby stuck in 2018. I ain't gonna hold you.
Yeah, nah, Baby needs some help. I ain't gonna lie. It's been a minute since he caught one. He's been trying. That's the crazy thing too.
That's what happens when you fucking throw Gunna under the bus like that. Bruh. That was your Ace Boon Coon, nigga. That was your best. Okay, because guess what? Gunna's album is anticipated.
Gunna's album is coming, and he got some motion. I ain't gonna lie, he got a lot of motion. I think Young Thug's dad just shouting him out and stuff like that too.
Yeah. And my thing is like, oh my god, like, dang, that was another duo that would have been like, I'm sad to see go, like, Baby and Gunna, like,
yeah,
damn.
Yeah, that was a time too. They had it on lock for a minute, man. All right, ASAP Rocky. When I first heard the record, I was like, okay, this shit might be something. It started all kind of hard in the beginning.
Necklace gave me shoulder cramps.
Pinky ring is show advance. Alright. I was like, this is the build up, you know what I mean? But Lord, the verse came in.
Oh.
Guys.
Him and his wife.
I ain't gonna lie.
I don't know. At this point, I've been waiting for music from Rihanna so goddamn long. I don't even want it no more.
You might as well have had your wife come and do this, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
I don't want it no more.
Rihanna can rap.
She will fuck up a beat. One thing about it.
Rihanna can rap. She could have probably done this way.
I don't know if I trust her for a whole album, but I damn sure I trust her for a feature.
Well, I'll say this. Well,
not Disney related.
You know what's crazy? And right, that was only one record. And that was, man, anyway. Rihanna's been out. We've been waiting for Rihanna longer than we've been waiting for Kendrick.
You better enjoy it, because that's all y'all getting. And she didn't even give us no heads up either. She was like, all right, watch this.
Right, she's like, I'm out. I'm like, Fenty Beauty is her priority, and the music shit, it is what it is. Ain't no money in it.
Should she have one more baby, we're going to get another album. Yeah. Shit. They're going to start eating her pockets alive.
Where's she at now? She at number three or number two? She said two.
She just had two, but I seen the picture. I'm like, they are lying to me. Get off of her.
Hey, yo. Nah, man. They going crazy. But I ain't going to lie. ASAP Rocky, it was warranted for him to get at Drake. But could have done it a different way. You know what I mean? If clearly music is not really your thing anymore, I see you maybe be trying to, you know what I mean, warm yourself up. You should have done some other stuff to warm yourself up before this. Because you can't go at this man. You can't go at this man's album and talk about it. Like, it's so funny how it came and went. Rocky, you dropped a single and nobody even heard it.
Bro.
So it's like.
The last time he dropped an album? It was like 2013?
I think the album was Testing.
Oh, yeah. I can feel the bass. That was like, I feel like. I remember that because that song was like actually on my
head. Yeah, testing 2018.
Oh shit. Okay, that was 2018. And yeah. That one, like, I was trying to play that, but niggas was not fucking with that joint. But I was fucking with it.
The testing album, I tried it. They had a record here with Kid Cudi. I think that one was alright.
I got distorted.
On my Buckshots, Praise the Lord was hard too. Praise the Lord was the one. That was the one right there. I ain't gonna lie.
Mm-hmm.
I
might have to revisit the album in general.
And then of course all the At Long
Last. Damn. You know what? I wish ASAP Rocky and ASAP Ferg was still homies too. For real. For real.
What happened with that?
I think ASAP Ferg was just an alcoholic and he wasn't really fucking with him no more, to be honest with you. I think what I read it somewhere.
Yeah, because I know Ferg dropped the ASAP name. He's just going by Ferg. But.
Oh, he is?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Google forever have him ASAP Ferg.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He's just Ferg.
Yeah, he goes by Ferg, but interesting. Ferg, where you at, man?
I don't know. ASAP Ferg, I'm sorry. Ferg always, like, I don't know, I've always liked his music regardless, like, even after ASAP, like, he got a...
His turn-up music is like, oh my god, perfect for festivals and concerts and stuff like that, it's a vibe, yeah, yeah, shout out to Ferg. Alright, but anyway, back to Rocky, nigga, don't do that again.
Don't let it happen again.
Yeah, I'm good.
Don't let it happen again.
I swear. Alright, I don't think there's anything else to touch on this album, Wilf. I think we pretty much...
How about we get to talk about Ross and what he had to say? Oh, wait.
Oh, yeah, you already know.
Wait.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's Aubrey.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Swinging. Okay.
He was windmilling y'all hoes. He said, bitch.
Nigga. All right. Guys. Aubrey Drake Graham. Okay. I was not expecting to get a quick response like this. Well, actually, no, I lied. I did. This is what I thought was going to happen because I had these conversations earlier. I think I said on the pod already. Mm-hmm. If the We Still Don't Trust You album comes out and there's a hard verse on there, like another Kendrick surprise or whatever, I think Drake wanted to see that album come out, see what was going on.
What was
going to
happen. It definitely sounded like he made that like recently. It didn't sound like he had it in a vault or nothing. Like,
for sure.
It definitely was. Okay, he was like, oh, all right.
That's
what I thought.
Yeah, he just wanted to make sure. He's like, oh, how crazy do y'all really want to get? And how many of these niggas, Carmen, we forgot one major part about the last album. I over forgot. I'm sorry. We got to go back. Just one little bit.
Uno momento.
Jermaine. Jermaine Cole.
Made his little appearance.
J. Cole is on Future's album.
Oh, yep. If you didn't know, now you know. That was definitely
a surprise.
Like, damn, did you switch teams?
Now, I'm going to be honest.
But he did y'all like say that he didn't want no parts, so he was just like, music.
Yeah.
Music, clap.
I ain't going to lie. Like, as soon as I got with, the niggas be leaking this second. As soon as the album dropped, I went to Rap Genius. I wanted to see like what the feature was going to be and everything. I saw J. Cole. I was like, these niggas got to be capping. I ran right to that record. I normally don't do that. Normally, I like to listen to the album one, all the way through.
I listen to everything through.
Yeah, that's how I like to do it. But when I saw this, I was just like, ain't no fucking way. I ran right to it.
Listen, what is this about?
I was just like, why would Rap Genius even do me like that? Like, why are you playing with me like that? But for sure, J. Cole is actually on this project. Me personally, I don't believe that J. Cole wrote this after his apology. I believe that this was already intended to come out and was already cleared.
Mm-hmm.
And now J. Cole still had the ability, I believe, to retract to pull it if he wanted to.
Man, he would have had to fucking send a what fucking SOS. Aubrey send a to get that his track pulled.
Cease and desist.
Yeah, do that.
Yeah.
I ain't doing all that. Fuck y'all niggas. I apologize.
Yeah.
Send your best shot.
Yeah, cause at first how I took this was like this was like a. This is like, yo.
Earthquake.
Stop it. I've been on the other side of the internet too much. Like,
bitch, no, I'm sorry. Side note, because I have to say this.
Yeah.
It was 80 fucking degrees today, and it started hailing.
It's hail?
The hail was like the size of a fucking like marble. Like it was endless hail for like 10 minutes. And I was like, what the shit is happening?
Right.
I thought somebody was knocking on my car because I was just sitting here typing out a long, drawn out, angry email. But nonetheless, it was hailing. And then it just stopped and melted and acting like life went on. And it, the sun came back out. I was like, what the fuck was that?
Yeah, no, that's some wild shit going on.
I'm sorry,
on.
But go ahead.
And I ain't gonna lie. Like, it's it went from 87 degrees and it's gonna be 62 tonight. That is a crazy drop.
Bro, where'd the hail come from?
Yeah, no, I don't know. Man.
Somebody, like, hit their elbow on the weather machine while they were fighting. Like, that Yo. Was really like.
NASA, what's popping, bro? Like, what y'all got going? Like, what y'all doing, bro?
Wild as shit. I'm like, nobody saw that? I didn't even see no one tweet about that. I'm like, what? It's 80 fucking degrees. Do you know hail season? Like, huh? Weather? Like, what is going on?
Coming soon. All right. Okay.
I'm confusion.
Yeah, I'm confused. J. Cole is on this album. I did originally think when I saw this, I was like, dang, did Future kind of make him do this? Like, how bad do you really want to apologize? Like,
gun to head.
Yeah, it's like, you know what I mean? Like, you did some wild shit.
Future said, you ain't doing that bitch ass shit over here.
Right, it's like, yo.
We already got it.
We need you to go ahead and, you know, prove to us what side you're really on and what you got going on and stuff like that. J. Cole has clearly said that he wants no parts of what is going on out here. I believe that J. Cole has heard the nuke from Drake or Kendrick's side and said, yeah, nah, this is deeper than rap, and I'm not with this. Like, even in his lyrics, he's like, yo, I'm just a college kid, nigga. You know what I mean? I'm a nice guy. I'm not a hood nigga. I just like to get a whiff. You know what I mean? He's making a scene. He's like, you know what I mean? Like, yo.
I'm just a nice guy. I just
like
to get a what?
Yeah. He was like, yeah. Like, I'm pulling the bar. Let me not mess up his bar. It's too crazy. The song is called Red Leather. I fuck with it. I think the record is just a little bit too long. You know what I mean? Like, it's like a 7-minute track, you know what I mean, of the rap. Mm-hmm. But, you know, hey, they got their shit off. And Cole was at the tail end of this thing. All right. So he says, my energy was never on the toughest nigga shit. I was just a conscious rapper that will fuck a nigga's bitch. I was just a college nigga from a rougher premises, kept my nose out the streets, but I love to get a whiff. You know what I mean?
You know what? No comment. Go ahead.
Leave the streets alone. If you're not a street nigga, leave the streets alone, man. Let the street niggas do what the street niggas do. Everybody play their part, you know what I mean? Like, this is a whole game of chess. Everybody should know their role and know their part, you know what I mean, and play accordingly.
Yeah, but you don't get to fucking pick your fucking pieces off the board and put them back. That's not how chess go.
That's facts. I ain't gonna lie. J. Cole just did a crazy surrender move, but it is what it is, man. All right. I don't know what this does. Well, I do know what this does. J. Cole also has debuted number 2 for his Mike the Lee later, which is the first time that he debuted not number 1. So clearly this has had some impact on his last project. He also removed the 7 Minute Later record like he said he was, but he waited for that first week to go by. So. Alright, so J. Cole and Future and Metro Boomin. Alright. Moving on. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the main event. Let's get ready to rumble, okay? This is the main event, all right? Right now, we are in the first quarter of Rap Beef. I'm loving the energy that's going on right now. This has resurged my interest in being back in Twitter and seeing what's going on. Like, I'm having fun on there now. Like, damn, it's been a minute. Like, I love the energy of what's going on now. So, guys. After the Metro Boomin and Future album, Aubrey saw that shit.
He said, I know y'all niggas ain't coming at me like that.
These niggas said, what
y'all jumping?
He said, y'all niggas 20
y'all
versus
niggas
1?
Jumping?
He's like, this is a 20 v 1 nigga? Like, I was like, yo, this is crazy. so, Anyway.
I'm fucking crying because, like. Because he got
the. Hey, I ain't gonna lie.
Listen, I just like to say, I'm here for the music.
Same.
But there's nothing you can ever say to make me hate Drake.
Oh, man.
Drake's the rap Beyonce.
Hey, yo. It is what it is, man. Like I, like she said, I'm here for the music. I'm a fan of hip-hop. I love hip-hop music so much. And I haven't felt this energy or had this much excitement for this genre of music in a long, long time. And this is something that I never thought we were going to actually get, but we're actually getting it in real time. These guys have been dissing each other for over a decade. Man. If you know, you fucking know.
I didn't know. I didn't know. I swear to God, I didn't know.
Yo.
I just be.
You be enjoying the music. Be vibing. You know what I mean?
I feel you. Ooh, who was that about? Okay.
Right.
I didn't know it was Randy.
You know, it's so crazy. Shout out to What's the Dirt. He has probably one of the best breakdowns on the internet that shows the whole Drake and Kendrick Lamar subliminal beef. For anybody that needs some catching up to figure out what's going on, go check out his channel. Really, really dope. What I'm going to do too, I think I'm going to make me a playlist. I'm going to make me a Kendrick and Drake subliminal playlist. So all the songs that have subliminal shots between the two coming up throughout the years, I'll put it on a playlist so you can have that. But I've been hearing every single shot that both of these niggas have been throwing, and now the gloves are off. Kendrick dropping the Like That verse has really sparked this shit. J. Cole tried to jump out there.
Nah, fuck that. Megan popped that shit off.
Megan
popped that shit off.
All right.
She said, posted in another nigga hood like a bad bitch. They said, yeah, fuck this nigga.
Hey, yo. Yo, she got a point. Shout out to Meg Thee Stallion. I ain't gonna lie. I haven't really heard.
Nah,
Outside of Kendrick, like, I don't really know that many other people that been going.
I wonder, at what point did Kendrick listen to that, if he already had it up his sleeve or not?
I wouldn't be surprised if we got a Meg and Kendrick record coming. I'm gonna be honest. I can actually see that. I can see that coming.
What does that even sound like? I mean, Meg's pretty versatile.
I can see that. Because a lot of people didn't think that Kendrick and Rihanna would do a record. That was also a diss to Drake as well, too. Like, yeah, I got your girl on my record with Loyalty. I know Kendrick leans more to like the more conscious side and stuff like that, but Kendrick can dance in
maybe
all
TD
these parties.
Kendrick.
Yeah, right.
That's they whole, like, I'm not gonna say they whole swag, but a majority of their artists is a lot of like black hippie gang. Like,
yeah, for sure. For sure. So guys, without further ado, we're gonna play the disc.
Yeah.
We're gonna break this thing down. We're going to see how many of these bars we can catch, break down, and explain to you guys. Because I know quite a bit, man. I know quite a bit. So, let's get right into it. This is Drake responding to Kendrick and others. This is called Push Ups, Drop, and Give Me 50. Yo, this is so crazy. Like, I've explained why it's called this, dude. This shit is insane. All right, let's get to it. Oh my
god. It was crazy for putting that joint on there.
Stop. Shout out to Wu Kid.
Hey, I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand.
Oh.
You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on.
Hold on. The first bar, I can never be nobody's number one. This is a direct shot at Future, where Future is like, you're my number one fan.
Oh.
And Drake is like, how could I be your number one fan when I put your first number one in your hands?
No, I thought he was talking about The Weeknd. He definitely did not put Future's first number one in his hand.
Future's first number one is with Drake. Future's first number one, yep.
Are you sure about that?
Mm-hmm.
Can we fact check that?
Sure, because let's do it. Sure. Future's first number one record. Because Wait For You was his third. Way Too Sexy is his first one.
wow.
When it charted number one.
Number one? Wow. Yeah. I thought Future. Oh, well, maybe not. Okay. Well, shit. All right.
Yeah, I would think that like something like a March Madness or something from DS, you know, Dirty Sprite 2 or something like
way
that.
Way before that.
Yeah, like.
Like the joint with Kelly Rowland. Like, what's this?
Oh, yeah, dang.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that's the number
I'm looking
one?
For. Yeah, but this is Future's first number one record.
I'm looking for. That didn't go number one. No. Oh, well, his record. Okay.
Yeah.
I think that the other one was Kelly Rowland.
No, even if he was featured on there, he would still be credited.
One. Damn. Okay. Yeah. All right. Shit.
Yeah. So, and this is crazy. And then after that, of course, with The Way For You with Tim's. So it's like he's. All his number ones are with Drake, and then his now third number one is with Kendrick Lamar. So now people are saying that Future can't get a number one record without Drake or now Kendrick.
For some reason, I thought that was somebody said it was Weekend he was talking about right there, but that might have been for him too.
It could be. Yeah, I think the Weekend. Well,
that's what I said. But I was watching somebody else's breakdown, and they said it was the Weekend. But that very much could be for Future as well. That's what I'm like.
Nah, he got it on his own. Can't Feel My Face is a solo Weekend record. That's his first number one.
First number one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because nothing on the trilogy went number one. Because remember, like, they came out as mixtapes, and he put them together, re-released them. None of those songs went number one. But
I'm talking about, like, what's the joint that he had? Goddamn! Never mind.
Is it on Trilogy? Starboy?
No, it wasn't on Trilogy. It was the joint he had with Drake. The one that was like, take your nose off my keyboard.
Oh, what you following me for?
Yeah.
You got a room full of niggas. Yeah, that was off of Take Care.
Crew Love.
Yeah, that didn't go number one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Damn. All
right. Yeah, so the Weeknd, and this is the thing, like, this has kind of been their back and forth. Like, The Weeknd's like, yo, like, I understand that Drake, you know, kind of helped bring me up a little bit, but, like, I still took off and did my own thing without you.
In a whole
you know
different
what I mean?
Direction.
Yeah.
All right, let's get back to it.
All right, yeah. So, yo, this is layered, guys. This is very layered. So, we're gonna get as much as we can get out of this. Oh, my God.
First number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you bitch stepping with a size 7 man's on?
Yeah.
Oh my God!
He had to do it.
I forgot he said that. Oh my God!
Hey, yo.
Oh my God! Oh my God! I forgot he said that.
Yo, he didn't have to
how
do my man like that.
How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on?
Respectfully.
That's my size.
Respectfully, Kendrick wears an 8.5 to 9. Respectfully.
Who said that?
Not a size 7, but put some respect. The 7 is still a kid shoe. The 7 is still a kid shoe.
I'm tall, though.
Hey, yo, put some Hey, Kendrick is not. I'm sorry, brother. Kendrick is 5'5". This is crazy.
No, bro, because he came at him in, like, 5 different ways.
No,
he
went
like,
nuts.
A midget, a fucking, little person, a size 7 man.
I had the hype down. We getting in front of the lyrics. Listen, Drake is going crazy. This is clearly, first shot was at Future. Second shot, we going straight for Kendrick. All right, let's get to it.
Bart with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, hope for red, you been shook up. This top told you drop it, give me 50 likes of push-ups. Huh, your last one.
God damn it. This bar right here. Because Top told you to drop and give me 50, like some push-ups. Top is Top Dog Entertainment, right? Mm-hmm. So Kendrick was under Top Dog Entertainment for all of his career. And he's alluding to every single thing that Kendrick was making. Half was going straight to Top Dog.
Give me 50.
Yeah. And now Drake has a crazy deal now where he gets paid from every artist. Like, Drake has a super mega deal where everything kind of gets streamed through him. So Drake gets paid from other artists. So now he's alluding to, like, yeah, drop something and give me 50 is what he's alluding to. Like, whatever Kendrick drops, I'm going to get something from it. Like, Drake has already been going crazy, like, yo, I want to buy your publishing and all this shit. Like, Drake is talking big boss shit, you know what I mean? Like, trying to little bro Kendrick on this record.
Brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50.
Nah, he didn't have to do this, man. Alright, he did crazy. So, he's now talking about how Kendrick has, kind of going to the pop lane to get, like, you know what I mean, popular. So Kendrick did a record with Maroon 5. Kendrick did a record with Taylor Swift.
Not know that.
Yeah, Kendrick was on Bad Blood Remix.
You said that like you were so disappointed. Yeah. Oh!
This is like...
Yeah.
Hey,
Unfortunately, Kendrick did.
Like, it's so crazy, like, how... I was, like, happy for him back there. Like, oh, he's finally getting some big shine and stuff like that.
I don't
from,
mind
you know what I mean?
I don't mind. I don't care. I'm just... You said so disappointed. Like, it was
a sad day when you bring it up like this. You know what I mean?
He was on Bad Blood.
Yeah. This was a Taylor Swift record that he did.
The remix.
Mm-hmm. So this was in 2015.
I don't want to visit that.
I promise you, we won't break this down.
Okay.
But yeah, he did Bad Blood. He also did a song with Maroon 5 as well too. But anyway, Drake is saying that, you know, pretty much you try to go pop. All right.
While we're breaking down Drake's fucking diss, a Drake Apple commercial comes on in the corner.
Hey, yo. Oh yeah, with him doing bench presses. Oh no, that joke was crazy. I seen the memes of this joint. This joint is not,
not okay. Not okay.
Oh,
we have to visit that
to
within.
Okay.
Is it long?
Let's see what's going on here. What's happening right now? We're all over the place, but here we are. It's top hill. Fuck it.
Cause baby, now we got bad blood.
No, what the fuck? Look what you've done. No.
Funny?
This gotta be AI. This could not be real, Drake.
Being funny?
There's no way. Hey, yo, no. That's crazy. That's actually crazy. That was 7 years ago.
Yeah, I was gonna say, he got hair now.
Yeah,
that aged was amazingly.
Bruh.
Considering that Kendrick was the feature, the remix, and he said, drop it, give me 50, give me push-ups. Like, whoa!
Nah,
that's
crazy.
Aged amazingly.
These niggas is so fucking strategic. I swear
and
to
calculated.
God. They're super calculated. Like, guys, this is insane. This is a lot of stuff going on.
Run it back. No, not the commercial, but let's get back to
the song. All right.
Do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. Pimp squeak, pipe down. Yeah, and then OB3. Scissor got you white down. Travis got you white down. Savage got you white down.
Hold on, no. Put some respect on my nigga's name. Hold up, wait a minute, man.
Better drop and give him 50. Pimp squeak, pipe down. You ain't in no B3. Scissor got you right down. Travis got you right down. Savage got you right down.
Like the label. That's like bending that man over and fucking him. Like that, was getting fucked. But I'm just like, I'm glad he's like, his contract is up, but yeah. Damn, you were getting bent over.
Yeah, I mean,
royally.
If this is real, I mean, I don't know if Kendrick is going to speak on this or Top is going to speak on this. I don't know if the split is actually 50-50. That is kind of crazy, but also it doesn't surprise me. The music industry is kind of wild. Like, it is a wild, wild west. And then Kendrick, honestly, Kendrick wasn't supposed to be the front runner of Top Dog Entertainment. He was never supposed to be. It was supposed to be J-Rock. You know what I mean? They were going with the street lane and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Kendrick just kind of came out of nowhere, but Yeah, and just like they started like putting him in battle raps and putting him in different places, and it's like, damn, this kid.
He's an underdog.
He was the underdog and literally shot past everybody and surprised the world. You know what I mean? So, but Kendrick was never supposed to be their front runner, but he just happened to grow into that. So, maybe he just stuck with that deal for the whole time and was just rocking with them because they have family ties too, like. Punch and Top, like they're cool with his pops and his family and stuff like that. So like it's, I don't know, but all right. So 50 is crazy. All right, so this bar right here, you ain't no in no big three. SZA got you wiped down. Now SZA puts posters up in her story and was just like, why I gotta bring me into this? Why my name in this? That whatever that housewife meme was.
Why you gonna put me in? Bring me into it.
Right. Now, SZA's a big star now, but I don't know about that. Travis, you can't rely on Travis for shit. This nigga is the flippiest of floppers of any. You don't want Travis got on your side because this nigga will go either way. He don't give a fuck. He will.
Does not give a fuck.
You could diss his wife tomorrow, and he'll go do a song with that op. Like he don't care. Travis is everywhere, so I don't know. I don't know about that.
He wakes up like Kanye. He's like, I'm gonna do what feels really. Right to me.
Literally. Literally did Sicko Mode, then went and did a record with Kanye. And then did the record with Kanye, then went right back to do a record with Drake. Like, he's just... Travis is out here having fun. He's like, I don't care. Like, I'm just...
I'm here for the vibes.
He's here for the vibes, man. So, there's that. And then this is the biggest cap. You said Savage got you wiped out. Now, that is cap. 21 Savage can't do nothing with Kendrick Lamar. I'm sorry. Respect the Savage, but no. That's not it. I don't know where that came from. But, anyway. All right. Let's get to this record. Boy, you in a scope right now, and you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. Kendrick labels. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to add his talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Crazy. Big swing, mic in and mic now. What the fuck is this, a 20V1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Give more love. That's the response from when Kendrick said, might be Michael Jackson, I'm Prince. Well, what's a prince to a king, nigga? You my son. So clever wordplay here with Drake. Yeah, this is insane, bro. Shout out to Drake for this, man. The hip hop needed this one, man. City that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make
Drums,
some drums, nigga.
Yeah.
Nah.
Get on the drums.
Nah.
Go make some music or something.
Nah. This is Drake is a menace to society.
You said, man, nigga, go make a beat.
Did you see Drake's story? Hold up.
His story? What the nigga post?
Oh my god. Drake is funny, man. That is a funny nigga. Hello?
Drake?
Drake?
Oh my god. He's a menace. The drum line.
Yeah. I played it right here for them.
He's a menace.
What is wrong with this nigga, dog? Yo, no. Nah, Drake is actually hilarious, bruh. He's actually hilarious.
He's showing
man.
Us on me. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah, I'm a six guy, I'm a front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Charles, no blunt runner. Playing a six and you boys ain't even come from it. Why would he go back? Bitch, you had a one from it. Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked. What? 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 You said what? You said what?
Oh my god.
Who?
You said claiming the six and your boys ain't even come from it. Alluding that The Weeknd is not actually from Toronto, but one of the suburbs outside of it. And then he says, when you boys got rich, you have to run from it. Cash is blowing Abel's bread out here tricking. So Abel's giving money to niggas when, like, he should be giving it to women. And Abel bread, that's like a Bible reference. This nigga getting biblical on these niggas. This is going crazy. He's going crazy on this, man. All right.
Spin it like you tryna fuck, boy, you trippin', boy, you trippin'. Drizzy chippin' there, probably got your bitch in there. I just got undone, boy, don't make me at the chippin' there. Rollin' loud stage, y'all would turn, that was slick as hell. Shit'll probably change if it beam start to kiss and tear. Hugs and kisses, man, don't tell me about no switches. I'll be rockin' every fucking chain I own next visit.
Ain't like that bar.
With some bodyguards like Whitney, top say, draw your little midget ass, better fuck it.
And this is right here. This bar right here is the one that got Kendrick out of bed. This is the one. Guys, I'll be rocking every fucking chain on my next visit, saying when I come back to LA. I be with some bodyguards like Whitney. Bodyguard being the movie, Whitney Houston. Mm-hmm. But you know whose name is also Whitney? Kendrick Lamar's wife. This is the one that got Kendrick out of bed. You said what? Drake is always coming for the girl, bruh. This is a menace to society. This is going crazy because this is still the jab. This is still not even the full beef. You know what I mean? And you already bringing my wife's name up? First round? Nigga, what? No. Nah, nigga. You guys,
But it's like, I'm gonna hit you where it hurt every time. I know right. This is what bothers you the most. I'm right. gonna put sure. my finger in your bullet wound, mm-hmm. and I'm gonna twist it in there, and say, ha, 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 ha. Like,
and this is what happens when niggas don't know that much about you. You know what right. I mean? So, like, they're gonna go with what they know.
What they know, right.
You know what I mean? So, like, he mentioned Whitney's name in his last album. Like, it's not a surprise. Like, Kendrick and his wife has been together. They've been high school sweethearts. So she's been around since the very, very, very beginning. So, yeah, man. So Drake really, this was the punch right here for me when I was just like, yeah, this is the one right here that got Kendrick out of bed. This is the one. All right. He proceeds. He's just like, he said, what? I know he did.
What you been hanging out with that nigga?
Somebody guards like Whitney, top say, draw your little midget ass, better fuck it.
Fucking messy as a bitch.
Oh yeah. We all know what's
just in case y'all ain't know. Drake dropped his diss.
Right.
It's called dropping to get 50 like me. Yeah.
The petty kings is out, man. I ain't gonna lie. With two petty kings niggas
are definitely out. The two pettiest niggas in the game. The goddamn petty ass Scorpio and a petty ass Cancer.
Swear to God, man. I ain't gonna lie. Them two niggas, nah, man, that's too much. That's too much pettiness. That's too much going on, man. But, yo, here we are. All right.
I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take your latest girl a cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in this nigga turning 50.
God, dog.
Wait.
I'm still not over the last bar, and now you're going at a whole nother nigga, dog. What the fuck?
Slow down.
You're like, I'm going back and forth, back and forth.
Wait a minute, nigga. Damn, hold on, wait. Oh.
And this goes to how clear and direct the drink is.
Didn't he give him a chance to duck?
Niggas is literally doing the Thanos meme right now with all the Infinity Stones. Like,
now, you know the meme where they was dumbing it. Let him up.
Oh my God.
Let him breathe.
Nah, Drake actually went crazy. This is literally like feels like a 20-v-1. Drake is just smacking everybody. All right, I might take your latest girl and cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe this nigga is jumping in. Turning 50. Every song that made it on the charts, he got it from Drizzy. Spend that little check, you gotta stay up out my business. Alright.
He's talking about Rozak. He's talking about Rick Ross here. All right. Rick Ross was on the last Future album and stuff like that. But this one kind of hurts. You know what I mean? In our intro to the pod, you know, we was playing some Drake and Rick Ross music. This one hurts, bro. I ain't gonna lie. This one hurt my heart. Because if you guys don't know, Rick Ross is probably one of the funniest niggas on the internet right now. Like, Rick Ross is fucking hilarious. Him, and that's why him and the 50 beef was so crazy, too. It was just two funny-ass, rapping-ass niggas just going back and forth. Like, Rick Ross is funny. Like, and he's quick. You know what I mean? Like, he'll see a tweet and just fucking hop on. He'll get a tweet and just fucking hop on there and just start going. You know what I mean? Immediately. So anyway, and this is kind of Drake saying, like, yeah, I might take your latest girl and cuff her like I'm Ricky. Kind of alluding, like, yeah, I was fucking with the last girl you was with. You know what I mean? Kind of like solidified that.
Because Drake wasn't, Ross wasn't even fucking with the last girl he was with. Bitch can't even make no tacos.
Hey, as soon as he got the ramen noodle plate, he was just like, yeah, I got to get rid of her. She can't even do the ramen right.
You seen it on his face, the disappointment. Yeah. Blasphemy.
He's like, nigga, you know I'm a fat nigga. You can't do me like that. All right, man, let's get back to it.
Talking like I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take your latest girl a cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in, this nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on the chart, he got some jizzy. Spend that little check, you gotta stay up out my business. Nigga, shout out to the Hooper that be busting out the grid. We know why you mad, nigga, I ain't even tripping.
All that John Morant. John fucking Morant caught a stray. Nigga, what?
I was gonna say, I don't watch sports. Yeah. I need to know what is.
John Morant caught a stray, man. God damn.
He said, and you too, bitch ass.
He was like, John Morant, I didn't even say nothing.
Did he not
know?
Like,
he
might have.
So this is what happened. Mm-hmm. All right. So when the first Future Metro album dropped, John Morant went ahead and tweeted, yeah, you. It's time for everybody to pick sides. Pretty much retweeting and stuff like that, hopping in. Okay, now why would John Morant just randomly hop in? You a ball player? You know what I mean?
He's still, you know, some people tweet like they're still civilian out here. You got a following, probably like a nigga who's like a regular old nigga. Like,
I was like, and John Morant been in so much trouble, you know, with the guns and shit like that. Like, he's been, you know, suspended from the NBA for a long time. He doesn't keep his head down. You know what I mean? Nose clear. Like,
shut up. Fuck up.
Like, do you want to continue making money or not? Do you want to continue being a player?
Drake go whispering in your coach's ear.
Right. And then it's already alluded that Drake got diplomatic immunity, man. Like, he just be doing some wild shit.
The way he be moving through Canada back to the United States, I wouldn't be surprised. Or Canadian.
Yeah, ass. I ain't. We got to talk about this.
We know some diplomats.
Yeah. I was going to tell you, we might need to do an episode to talk about the Drake and XXX situation, because there's a lot of records that allude that Drake is saying, like, yeah, I killed you, nigga, type shit. But anyway, that's a different episode. We're not going to get into that today, but yeah.
With his own bare hands, or got it happen, made it happen.
Made it happen. Made it happen.
I wonder why.
XXX was talking about Drake's mother on live.
Is that what happened?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll get there. This we can have a whole nother episode for that, but yeah, that shit was crazy. SMS, XXX. SMS is another phrase for semi shooters. XXX. Anyway, all right. Back to this. John Morant caught it stray. The reason why he did that tweet, siding with Metro. Reason why he did that. Drake took the girl named Brooklyn, who apparently is a Lotto's sister. They both, John Morant used to date her, stopped dating him, starts fucking with Drake. That's what happened. So that's why Drake is saying here, where is the bar? He said, nigga, shout out to the Hooper that be busting out the gritty. We know why you mad, nigga. I ain't even tripping. He's like, I know why you mad. I did it, nigga. Surprise. Drake is a... Drake, this is a real menace to society. All right, let's keep going.
We know why you mad, nigga. I ain't even tripping. All that little heartbroken Twitter shit for bitches.
Thanks.
This for all the top dogs dropping, give me 50, drop.
In that fucking song, y'all got to not start the beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that Doc shit was weak as fuck. Champagne tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Nigga call the top to see if Top wanna piece it up. Top wanna piece it up, Top wanna piece it up. Nah.
Alright. Addressing Cole here. Shout out to my boy Austin, man. He gave me a different outlook on this bar here, which gave me a different perspective. First, he's saying that song Like That on here, this is not what started the beef. Drake wanted to make it clear, like, yo,
man, we've been doing it.
Yeah, we've been going back and forth. This was bound to happen. This is not because of, like, that Future Metro. I don't want to give you any more clout. Get out of here. Cool. But this next bar, I don't care what Cole thinks. That Dot shit was weak as fuck. Now, continuing on, he says, champagne tripping, he's not fucking easing up. Niggin calling Top to see if I want to piece it up. Top want to piece it up. And he's like, nah, pussy nigga, you on your own when you speaking up. This can all be directed for J. Cole. Where J. Cole is saying he went to Top to try to piece things up after the mistake. And Drake is finding up, like, you want to ask Top, you want to piece it up? Nah, nigga, you on your own type shit. You know what I mean? Like, this could be taken in that way. Different perspective. I don't know what the... I want to know what the annotate says. Yeah, people are saying they still think it's referencing Cole. Because Cole is saying that he wants peace.
Yeah, like... But I said that when we was listening to... J. Cole's diss, like,
yeah, the 7 minutes.
I was like, nah, Drake gonna be like thrown off, like, fuck is you on, nigga? Like,
right, right. Now I'm gonna diss you, like we said,
nah, I'm about to stand on what I'm saying, and you're about to catch the casualty of this, like, you are no longer gang.
But facts, and like I said, J. Cole not performing First Person Shooter is a big deal. That's his number. It's his most recent number one record.
Facts.
Why would you not play that in front of 52,000 people of your fans?
That's your event.
Yeah, that's a robbery. So, like, there's something clearly there. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So, I do believe that this bar is alluding to Cole saying he went to Top saying that, yo, Champagne is tripping. Like, he's about to bug out. I heard the nuke he has for Kendrick. He's about to bug out and trying to piece things up. And Cole seems like he's being the peaceful guy in this thing. Like, Cole is the one going on Drake's record talking about it's a big three. Like, is it Aubrey, Kendrick, or me? Like, he's trying to bring the big three together. You know what I mean?
And they've been like, nah, fuck that.
Yeah, fuck both of you. Like, you know what I mean? Drake never acknowledged the big three. Kendrick never acknowledged the big three. It was only J. Cole. So, this makes sense. Begging Kyson, that boy, you're not fucking beating us. Now he's alluding here that this is possibly somebody from Kendrick's camp trying to get with Kyson to go on stream. I seen Kyson Nap's reaction. It's pretty funny. He acts like he don't know what they're talking about. It's just only labels.
Like, you know, I don't.
He's like, ain't no rapper that he knows be trying to beg to come on stream. He be talking to labels. He don't know what he's talking about. He's like, who begging? You know, doing his Kyson Nap thing. But,
like, everybody can come on my show. What are you talking about?
Right. Yeah. Interesting. All right. Let's finish this.
All the top to see if Top wanna piece it up. Top wanna piece it up. Top wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You don't roll deep to this, you're not fucking deep enough. Begging cops or not, boy, you're not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you're not fucking creeping up. Money wise, I'm out of here, you're not fucking sneaking up. Corn ball, your show money, merch money, feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because I seen enough. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up. Drop and give me 50.
All right. Shout out to DJ Academics. This is a sample that he got from his stream. This is Academics. Academics has been going fucking crazy these past couple of weekends. I'm not gonna lie. I've been tuning in. Shit is fucking amazing. This nigga's been streaming for fucking 47 hours straight, just giving us hip hop news, letting us know what's going on, and people.
Kendrick.
Hey, Ack went crazy on Kendrick. Like, what top five you smoking on Kendrick? Because, you know, Ack is Drake is Ack's favorite artist, so Ack be riding Drake, whatever. But I do think that in this new age, I'm liking what I'm seeing. When I'm re-entering the Twitter world, right? Mm-hmm. There's a lot of AI. There's a lot of fake things going on. So it's kind of fun to figure out, like, what's real, what's not, you know what I mean? Kind of digging through the rough to figure out what it is, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And then you have sources like a DJ Academics, a Say Cheese, a Joe Budden, Elliot Wilson, some of these guys who are, like, tapped in and stuff like that, mm-hmm. that's going to give you the updated news. Like, these are, like, the new hip-hop platforms to go to actually get it. And it's dope to see it in real time.
In real time, right, yeah. Right.
ACK is the only one that's, like, live. Where, like, back in the days, people had to go to the radio station to give them the demos and the tapes and play it.
You gotta wait on Wendy Williams.
Bruh. But, you know, now it can literally be 3 a.m. in the morning. ACK is up, and you just send the file to him, and then, you know what I mean?
Oh!
And
then
so, and then Joe comes with the podcast later on, stuff like that. So, anyway, I've been really enjoying it, and I think, I know ACK has been, like, going crazy, like, happy that he's sampled on Drake's disc record, so that's dope. Now, this is where things get interesting. This is the
end. Oh, but wait, there's more.
There's more. All right, let's finish this thing up. This beat switch up is nuts. Yeah, drop a 50 bag for the mob in the spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the car.
Like, oh, there's gonna be a part two, and it's gonna be a radio hit.
these bars right here. All right, he's begging Kendrick.
He's like, come on.
Yo, I ain't gonna lie. I've never
get this shit out of here.
He's like, drop, like, please drop it. Drop your fucking record. Let's fucking go. That's what he's saying. He's like, drop that shit.
And maybe that is like what you were saying earlier. Like, mm-hmm. maybe that does reference to like Drake's getting half all of this shit, regardless.
Yeah,
like, come on, drop.
Drop. I'm gonna get fed.
Get some. Yeah. Get some. Come on, drop.
Right.
It's gonna go up. I'm gonna get paid. Come on, drop.
Right.
Drop.
He's been wanting to get rid of the rumors of people thinking that Drake is scared of Kendrick or this, anything like that. Drake's like, I know, I want to smoke. I'm ready for it. Kendrick is the one that I haven't been seeing lately. Like, I don't know what's going on with him. Like, is it directed to me or not? You know what I mean? So now he's like, okay, here's it. You jab me. Everybody wants to see it. I'm going to jab you back. Let's give him a show. Kendrick. And then this is the last part right here, too. Like you said, the beat switch up into a club hit. This is letting you know, hey, I got more. I'm ready for you. Whatever you got, I'm ready for you. And the last line, I was really trying to keep it PG. Another flip on words, what's Kendrick's label name? PG Lang. What are you saying? I was trying to keep it PG. I was trying to keep it cute. I was trying to keep it safe for the kids. You know what I mean? But nah, nigga, you went at me, it's time to go. Fuck it. So that I loved how he finished this record right here. It got me fucking hyped. I'm ready for this shit. Hip hop is alive, 2024, man. And I said that we was gonna try to get through this in an hour, and I lied. Carmen, what is your reaction of this record? What do you think of it in totality?
It's just like, to expect Drake to miss is a wishful thought. I'm excited to see. I really want to know what Kendrick got. Because, like, don't sleep on him.
Yeah.
I would really be disappointed if he disappointed me. But it's like, Kendrick might not drop as much. But when he does deliver, he does deliver.
That's a fact.
So, I'm not saying he's Drake. But he is Kendrick. Mm-hmm. So, I'm going to put some respect on his name. So, I'm excited to see, like, oh, how far y'all niggas going to go with this? Like,
yeah.
Who's going to have the last laugh is what I want to know.
Yeah, man. I ain't going to lie. Hip-hop win. I want to hear both these nukes. I heard both of these nukes are crazy. I think they
both fuck around and be radio bangers, and they just play back to back. It's like, oh.
Oh, my God. Everybody has to get out the way. Everybody has to get out the way now. This has been...
Get out the way. Let these niggas dance.
This has been disruptive. I ain't going to lie. Let these niggas dance. This has been disruptive. And the crazy thing is, Drake did this record, and...
He sure enough did this, like, in a few days. Like, if not.
Yeah, that. For sure.
Like, this is, like, recent information. Like,
and he dropped this in a random Saturday at 2 p.m.
We niggas wouldn't have even known if 50 Cent... 50, well, I'm not going to say niggas wouldn't have known, but, like, I sure wouldn't have Cause but 50 Cent was like, nah, y'all, look, yeah, y'all. They fighting.
I ain't gonna lie. And because what happened was the Rough track came out first. So the Rough came out, it had the Get Money, it had that beat first. So that one was going out. And everybody was trying to figure out, was it AI, was it real or not? People was just like, okay, this sounds like Drake. Right. But it's like, it's missing something. It's kind of off. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And then I was watching Axe stream. Somebody sent it to me. He's like, stop playing that shit. Here's the real one. And then he plays it. And I'm like, oh, shit.
They said, nah.
Yeah.
I got straight drop for you.
Yeah. And this is the beauty about the leaks situation, too. A lot of people I know are mad at the leaks. I actually grown to like it because it's forcing the artist to hurry up and get the shit out of here.
Yeah, like.
You don't want this shit to start catching fire and them start talking shit about you. Get the real shit out of here. Let's go. You know what I mean? So I appreciate that part of, you know, the songs getting leaked and stuff like that. So, guys, we're here. The main event time. Kendrick versus Drake 2024. I'm excited. And Kendrick is your go.
You got to put the little ding, ding, ding on our
joint. I know, right? I need to find a Let's Get Ready to Rumbles, something like that. But yeah, I ain't going to lie. Kendrick, I really want him to drop at least by Friday. I know some people are giving him longer, giving him 2 weeks. They say, well, Drake had 2 weeks because he was waiting for the Metro feature album. Kendrick should have more time, too. But, like, Kendrick's been ready. Like, he dropped, like, that verse because he already had something. Like, so we know Kendrick is ready.
For people to still not think that Kendrick moves strategically.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to say he started the beef because clearly niggas already been feeling the way with Drake. But
yeah.
Kendrick came out swinging with all anticipation.
Right.
That Drake was going to drop something. And everybody universally knows that Drake doesn't miss. So yeah. It's like.
And Kendrick said the verse, he's like, no, it's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Like, you know what I mean? Saying like, yo, I want this too. So, you're inviting it. Drake's inviting it. Both of y'all want the other person to go first. Fuck it. But I respect Drake for actually throwing a jab.
Send the smoke up.
Yeah. It's up. No more jabbing. Throw a punch. We can't take no more jabs. Nigga, we're done with the jabs. Drake did a hell of a power jab. Kendrick, if you come back with another power jab, I'll be mad. Because there was another leak that came out here. I was like, no,
Not this.
This can't be. This I know. This is not my favorite rapper, Kendrick Lamar. Get this shit out of here.
Like Kendrick has dropped so much music. Like that could have been some. Like, I'm not gonna say some old shit, yeah. But like it definitely like didn't give like current.
Yeah. No. That was like.
But I heard at least.
Yeah. I heard a couple of Jones. I ain't gonna lie. One of the Russ was fire. I was like, oh my god, where is this? Didn't even drop. Yeah. Like, yo, exclusive. Yeah. Exclusive. Yeah. Send that to the phone, nigga. But yeah. Guys, we're here.
Two lies and the truth leaks.
All right. Let's go!
Man, let's hear this other joint.
Yeah.
Let's get to it.
All right. Yo, that was a long drop. All right. Like, we really rumbling. Okay. Guys, just when you thought that, you know, we're just going to be sitting here waiting for a Kendrick response. In 2 hours.
We hear the fucking stone cold glass break.
Bruh.
Royal Rumble. Who was that?
Hey, yo. This is funny. This is hilarious. This is actually dope. But
I hate
this
that
is,
picture.
Which one? The Drake or the Rick Ross?
Rick Ross. Like, bro, why you got that much fucking chalk, I mean, not even chalk, fucking goddamn beard liner.
The little draw on jump. Yeah, man, he went kind of crazy with that. But, Drake.
I'm sorry.
No, you good. Rick Ross decided to respond to Drake. First, he responded within 2 hours. I love Rick Ross. I think Rick Ross makes incredible music, makes like cinematic albums, a very talented writer. He does his thing, and he's a boss, you know what I mean? Like, I like that he teaches and shows you real money-making moves and stuff like that in his lifestyle, you know what I mean? And he's still a cool-ass nigga. He's funny and shit, too. So, you know, Ross is dope, you know what I mean? And he also has a long history with Drake, has amazing music together. I got a playlist again. I've been rocking their playlist with like the Drake and Rick Ross collab. I've been rocking that joint for a minute, like it's an album. That shit is fire. They have some great music together. But Ross did not like that shit that Drake said on that verse. And
yeah, I told your ass not to say that shit.
And I know
then
Ross
got a problem with me.
I know Ross is talented, but I don't know if he really did that shit in 2 hours. Like that's kind of almost it. Did this shit in 2 hours is kind of incredible. I ain't gonna lie. I think he already had this laying somewhere. Maybe he made a few touch-ups and then released it. You know what I mean? But
I mean, but then again, Ross don't really be making music like that for me to even gauge that. Like, maybe it just was like, huh. Like, every time Ross raps, it sounds like he's telling a great story.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And because he's done that so many times, it's like, even if he did or didn't, like, it wouldn't sound like it because he just got that voice. Like, his voice is so commanding. So mm-hmm. It's like he could say some real shit. And I feel like just the way he carries himself, like, he wouldn't put out anything he didn't think sound good. So we wouldn't be able to really know
right.
to gauge that.
Right.
Just because he don't put out music like that no more. He's, like, right. fucking milking cows and shit.
Nigga, it does have, like, a whole farm. All right. This is Rick Ross, Champagne Moments. The diss to Drake. Let's get to it.
Fish tanks and marble floors, living big and bad. Niggas laugh until they hit with my official jab. Crack smoke is the exhaust from my pen and pad. Ghost writers, they get the floss, what you could have had. Record label taking a loss, are you in your bag? You a worker wanting the chart, don't make me laugh.
Now. I cannot stop laughing at the fucking album artwork.
Oh.
What is wrong with this nigga?
Cause there's really a man out here.
Oh.
There's really somebody out here who looks like
this. No, Ross is fucking hilarious, bro. No, and this is officially out on DSP. Ross is a marketing genius. Ross said, I'm gonna get in the middle of this shit. Fuck it. Numbers is up. This is all marketing, man. But let's get back to it, man. What the fuck?
Hit the mind, tell by my watch, this a different time. Living fine, I'm getting high, it's your shit decline. Who believes he moving keys in his Louis V's? Run up on you and snatch your chain, watch you bitches bleed. Feel the pain or just describe where you really ride. Either you niggas getting money or ready to die. B.I.G. or give a fuck if you T.I.L.E. You got it and you keep it tucked if you be by me. Do the job, better known as the Charles Schwab. Double R, spread through the yard and I swear to God. Pop a perk for the field. Go and count me a meal. Kill you niggas for free. Do it all for the thrill. Niggas leaking their records when we speaking directly. If we keeping the gangster, when you see me, you check me.
I swear to God, like if you was to go on Google and type in Rick Ross type beat, like this is exactly what's gonna come up.
Yeah, for sure.
Like
for sure.
He sure enough got like that's his sound.
Very easy. He probably got like 100 records like this. Already ready to go type shit. You know what I mean? I feel like Rick Ross might have like a record for every rapper on a beat like this. It's like, all right, there's the Drake one. Here's the one for Chance the Rapper. Here's the one for whoever wants it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like that
getting bullied, like, don't walk up on me because the clip is fully. Niggas pussy
like
don't want to push me. I'm like, really, Woody?
Yeah, he's like, hey, yo, Jay, I got
like,
something for you.
We above certain shit.
Yeah.
High-class niggas.
Yeah, you know what I mean? This is all high-class shit. All right.
Like his moves, but he never had a fight at school. Always ran, another nigga had to write your grooves. Flow was copying your pace, Weezy gave you the juice. Another white boy at the park, wanna hang with the crew. Pull it surprise when I'm switching up like dyed denim. Getting sentenced for all the killings while we ride rentals. Look me right in my face, he beginning to shake. Told you niggas stay scheming, I predicted my fate. Got more money than you, fuck you want me to say. 50 meals for the crib, where you want me to stay?
I ain't gonna lie. Ross is talking the shit on here.
You know, he surely was.
He's really talking
like,
the shit
like,
on here.
I am not gonna hold you like Ross this might have been the one that actually made Drake feel away.
Yeah.
Like
for
the
sure.
rest of the niggas, he probably be like, light work. He probably looked at that and was like, nigga, what you just say to me?
Right.
He probably really felt some type of way about that.
Yeah,
like
no.
not like how he might have felt some type of way when niggas was talking about his mom or his son. Like it's like, oh, that's something personal. Like, no, Ross is the only nigga that's actually getting at Drake. Not talking about the people around Drake.
Right.
Getting at Drake.
Yeah.
Like, he know his personal business. Like, there's not too many people who can actually do that with Drake. Like, they can just talk about people around him or scenarios that he's been in with women or things like that, but not about him.
Exactly,
so personally. So that's where, you know.
From the start, too. Yeah, you made a good point, because Ross was there in the very beginning.
From
the,
yeah.
You know what I mean? When they were putting Drake on.
Type
like,
shit.
When they were, like, solidifying him, bringing him in the hood, bringing him to Miami and Houston and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Like, Drake needed... You know, everybody knew, like, back then, Drake was soft. So, people, niggas wasn't too sure about Drake. He's like, you know what I mean? Should I be listening to this nigga? He be singing and shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But Rick, he brought him on I'm On One. He brought him on Stay Scheming. He brought him on these records that gave him some legitimacy into hip-hop. Right. So, Rick Ross is like, you owe me, nigga. You owe Birdman. You owe Wayne. Like, you know what I mean? So, yeah, this stuff is personal. This is way back. When you got somebody that can go back over a decade with you, with some tea and some dirt and stuff like that. This is all, I ain't gonna lie. Yeah, Drake got a heart out, you know what I mean? But here we are.
Shoot up the block, I got pictures to paint. Let you DM my hoes, but got bitches you can't. Let you get on my songs, it was good for your face. Now bitch nigga is home.
I told you they like that bitch.
The perk for the field, go and count me a meal. Kill you niggas for free, do it all for the thrill. Niggas leaking their records when we speaking directly. If we keeping the gangster, when you see me, you check me. You never wanna be a nigga anyway, nigga. That's why you had operation to make your nose smaller than your father.
Get that yam off your face, nigga.
Because you said the motherfucking system desist to French Montana. You said the police, nigga, had an Emma Dog project. That was the same white boy that I seen, nigga, when we were making them early records, nigga. When you were happy to be around, nigga, saying niggas holding them sticks. Yeah. You old motherfucking stunning your life, nigga. Get Weezy some more money, nigga.
This is how you know Rick Ross is the hood nigga for real,
though. How you wanna do it, where you wanna do it, anytime you wanna do it. I'm ready, white boy. Huh? I know you got your doctors on with no underwear, white boy. Yeah, you had that surgery, that six pack on, that's why you wearing that funny shit at your show. You can't hide.
You hear that part?
What?
You didn't hear that part?
Your doctor's on with no underwear, white boy. Yeah, you had that surgery, that six pack gone. That's why you wearing that funny shit at your show. You can't hide it, white boy.
Oh my god, man.
Doubling down on what makes it.
Yeah. Lord have mercy. All right. What are your thoughts on this Rick Ross response to Drake? Chip, my take, Rick Ross, if this is indeed your pen working at with only 2 hours of time and coming out, this is absolutely fucking phenomenal. People forget where Rick Ross is from, man. Like, yeah, he's almost 50, but he's been around that era of hip-hop where, like, niggas really used to get at niggas. You know what I mean? Like, and you could tell, you know, Rick Ross be around street niggas and stuff like that. Nigga, he's gonna say shit. Yeah, it's not gonna, it may not be true, but who gives a fuck? You know what I mean? He's just gonna say shit that's funny. Say that Drake got a nose job, even though he doesn't have a nose job. It doesn't matter. It's funny. We know Drake is, you know, mixed. We know Drake got a black dad, but he's still going to call him a white boy. You know what I mean? Like, it just is what it is. You know what I mean? You know? It just is what it is. That's what hood niggas do. It's what street niggas do. They don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? They're going to say what they want to say. It is what it is. They're going to rock with it. And that's what it is. You know what I mean? So, like, yo. This shit is funny, but this is hip-hop. And this is, like, real gritty, beefing-type hip-hop where niggas is getting at each other. They're taking personal shots. This is dangerous for Drake. This is a blind side for Drake. I don't think that he expected Ross to be coming at him like that. That's why he even said, like, I can't believe this nigga. I thought he was going to be retired. You 50, making money. Now this nigga claiming he making more money than Drake. I don't know if that's true or not, but he Ross got bread.
Livestock.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. Them taxes.
Shit.
I swear to God, that the fucking bull taxes, fucking USDA.
Bethune need king size beds, nigga.
Bruh. got one of the largest mansions in the whole entire country, making money off of that. Like, Ross has been making some big money moves, you know what I mean? So,
we love a businessman.
Yeah, like, that nigga, when he says I'm a boss, he really fucking meant that shit, you know what I mean? Like, he doesn't leave any money behind. I was listening to an interview, shout out to Earn Your Leisure. Rick Ross was at InvestFest 2 years ago, performing. That shit was fire. He had an event in New York City. InvestFest was in Atlanta. He did the event in New York, flew to Atlanta. He also had an engagement, a party to go to, an after party to go to in New York. This nigga literally was performing in New York, flew to Atlanta, performed in Atlanta, flew back to New York to do his show. Like, it's just like, bro, like, what type of work ethic are you doing? Like, it's shit crazy where most people are just like, nah, I can't do this date because of this. He doesn't let any money slide. He doesn't care how much, it's a bag over there, I'm gonna go get it. That's who Rick Ross is, and I respect that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. There's too many lazy ass niggas out here who don't want to do no shit.
Not even just lazy, but get comfortable.
Complacent. Facts. Big facts. Niggas, like, I'm talking to the niggas. Niggas, there is no time to be comfortable. We are in a motherfucking recession. You hear me? They don't want to tell you, I'm telling you. This is a recession. Every single bag that you can get it. Every single dollar you can save, save it. I'm trying to tell you, bro, like for real. Like, I'm even finding ways. I'm finding any ways to make some money right now. I don't care. Legally. No Diddy. You hear me? Like, so, but yeah, man, like, hustle. Like, hustle, man. So, anyway, dope. Loved it. All right. I already know what type of episode this is. We're going to do one more thing on this, and we're going to be done for the night. All right.
What is that? What's going on?
Yo, shout out to RDC World. These are some funny ass niggas, dog. These niggas is fucking hilarious, mo.
Is this like after Cole's apology?
Yes.
Please. I absolutely am yearning for this. I need this. Oh!
This is entitled How Future and Metro Were in the Studio After Drake Dropped His Diss. So this is after the Drake diss. Let's get to it, man. Oh my god.
Nigga, swing the mic in and mic now. What the fuck is this, a 20V1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get more love in a city that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah, I'm a sick.
Metro, don't listen to that nigga.
Oh, bro, he's not. Don't listen to that nigga, bro.
Yeah, fuck that shit, Metro. I'm ready to slide back on this nigga right now.
Who is that?
The Weeknd. That's The Weeknd. You know, you see Abel right there?
It's
Abel.
Not.
It's XO. You
that
know?
Is disabled. Fuck no.
Hey, Young. Hey, Young. Chill, bro. Oh, my God. Shit.
Fuck that shit, Metro. I'm ready to slide back on this nigga right now. All right,
we can't. Please stop talking, bro.
Just saying.
Y'all already know we got a plan. Come on, let's do this right now. Hey, we want to appreciate all y'all for coming to the studio to diss Drake. Y'all be there?
Well, I said, yo, that nigga got me fucked up.
Who's that?
Right, he's in the studio. That's cool. To diss Drake again for the third time. We about to drop a condom?
Yo, my black dudes. Yeah, it's me.
How the hell you got beef with Common?
Yeah, you got me back in State Scheme, remember?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
All right, man. See, I told y'all, man. Drake be tripping, bro. He be dissing everybody. He diss Common. Y'all, bro, I think you should let that go. But, man, it's a few niggas in the studio. I just don't. The Chance? Fuck, bro.
Not him again.
Hey, Young. Hey, no. Like, not this nigga. Get him out of here. Oh my god.
I just don't. The Chance?
Fuck no. It's the Chance.
Chance, what are you doing?
He dissed me on draft day. Remember? Pick a name like Chance the Rapper. Come on.
Yeah. Bro. That's a reach. That's a reach.
Yeah. You doing it. Chance, bro. Get up out of here, bro. Get out of here, Chance.
Oh, this is some bullshit, man. this nigga dirty, dog.
All this, man. Some of y'all should be here, like Pusha T, Rick Ross, I guess, after Drake gave you all the fucking hits. Wait, where Ross go?
Don't ask about the bullshit right here.
This nigga went to the show real quick.
I went and I laid a track down. I did track. The beef is over.
I already handled it. Done. Don't worry about it. We got you. It's done.
You're done. You're dead.
Oh my God. It's over with. It is over with.
You don't wait on nobody. You make your own decisions.
All right, Ross.
And another thing, I'm really proud of everybody.
All right. I said, all right, but we're trying this out. All right, Rick. Damn. All right. You know what? I just don't know if we can make hits for everybody in this room. Like, Luda, what is Luda doing? You and Drake don't like each other? Stand up!
Oh, man.
Bro, don't film fast enough, bro. I'm not listening. Bruh. Most definitely get the fuck out of here.
Hey, yo. Hey, yo.
Hey, what is...
Big ass scarf.
Oh, shit.
Who is this dancing in the back?
What?
It's fucking... Oh, no. Hey, bro. Hey, look at this. Hey, we call that mom. I don't care, bro. Drake got this round, bro. Hey,
yo. No.
Oh my God! Nah, give these niggas a round of applause.
RDC World here. Now I know y'all wondering what we got coming up next. Let me tell you, short film. Imagine that. We've been filming. We've been filming and filming in hours and hours and hours. And Drake, y'all keep dropping shit, and they keep messing up film days. You gotta stop and go do everything. Now people talking about where's the call video? Where's the call video? I already explained to you we made the call video, but we didn't drop it. We actually made two cold bills, right? One Mike Delete later dropped, and another one an apology dropped. Now look, this is what I'm gonna tell y'all.
Where is it at?
Most likely. Because we also made a Drake video before Drake dropped. We ain't picking on sides. It gets everybody getting old out here. But look.
Respect.
I think we're gonna put all the videos in one video together.
This is not a beef you can pick sides in. Everybody makes great music.
I don't have a good playoff video.
You just gotta sit down.
That's what I'm seriously thinking about doing.
Nah, you preaching right now. Like, yeah.
That when it come down to it, everybody in this beef makes great music.
Right.
When we lay, that's why they're able to be.
Yeah.
Because they're able to sit in the same room.
Exactly. Everybody wins. Honestly, the rappers, well, not everybody, not all the rappers win. Some rappers gonna lose. But
give me 50.
Right, bruh. But everybody that surrounds the hip hop generation, the people, the content creators, the streamers, the podcasters, everybody around eats and wins off of this kind of stuff. So yeah, it's really hard to pick sides. It's just, we're just fans of the music. We're enjoying it, you know what I mean? All right. But anyway, yeah, let me just give them a round of applause. Shout out to them. They said they got, you know, they did the video. They just hadn't released them yet, so I'm hoping that they do eventually drop them. So anyway, shout out to them. Give them a round of applause. Shout out to RDC World. All right, guys. Tonight was a special episode, man. I know some of you guys are going to be mad. We didn't get to any reactions tonight. We started late, but I promise you guys, next week, we'll be back on schedule. We're going to do some more reactions for you guys. We're going to get back over to the continent. This is a lot of shit.
There's a lot going on over here right now, okay?
It's a lot
of shit going on,
yeah.
Okay? You got to clean your house before you go to someone else's.
Preach. I'm sorry. There's some hip hop shit going on here. We gotta take care of it. We hope you guys still enjoyed it, and you know, hope we'll be able to fill you guys in on what's going over here on this side. You know what I mean? And then we'll get right back over there with it as well too. But listen, man, you got Drake sending missiles, Kendrick sending missiles, Future sending missiles, Iran sending missiles.
Missiles sent.
Yo, the world is getting wild out here. The whole world is getting wild. Solar eclipse is doing stuff.
Rap apocalypse.
Yeah, the rap apocalypse. Honestly, because once this is over, y'all, I ain't gonna lie. Yo, if we don't get no more Drake, Future, Kendrick, or Cole, I'm done with hip hop. I'm good. I'm actually good.
I'm saying you're not gonna get no more.
I'm just saying.
I think niggas might take a breather.
Like, yeah, they might take some time. But I'm just thinking, like, if we didn't have those four for hip hop, what would hip hop be?
This might be the renaissance we need, though.
Facts. That's a good point. To, like, resurge that energy back into the culture to get some people really rapping again and appreciate it. You know what I mean?
We need like some, and maybe like after this is all said and done with, we could kind of like put the rest, the sample wave that we've been on. Like, I want to hear some fresh shit.
Yeah, we need a new wave. You know what I mean? Like, I think Drake, Kendrick, and Cole kind of ran the generation, but there needs to be some successors. You know what I mean? Future ran it too. There's a lot of Future babies out there. You know what I mean? There's a lot of Drake babies out there.
Free Jeffrey.
Free Thug. Free
what
Thug.
What would these last fucking 10 years be if we can't say Thug? Free Jeffrey.
Yeah, no, shout out to him. For real. I think Gunna's doing a good job of, like, you know, keeping the torch up, even though, you know, niggas was doing whatever they were doing, but Gunna's still dropping great music. Matter of fact, shout out to him. He's going to be releasing a new project coming soon. Got a new project. And you guys already know, Gunna's been in, like, his Applebee bag as well, too. So I'm wondering if you got any surprise collaborations on here, you know what I mean? So, what is the cover art? I swear I hate blogs sometimes. Anyway, this is the cover art for it, so.
Ooh.
Looks dope.
Did he put a date on it?
Let's see. He did say the joint is called Out of One. I think is what the name of the album is. Let's see. One of One is the name of the album. And he just says on the way.
Yes, sir, Steve.
All right. We'll be waiting on it. We'll be waiting on it. All right, guys. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to another episode of the Top Hill Podcast. We greatly appreciate it. We'll be back to our regular scheduling programming next week, I promise. Unless Kendrick Lamar decides to respond or some other crazy. Enjoy the ride, niggas. Enjoy the ride. We're going through a season right now. Enjoy the ride, you know what I mean? And we'll get right back to it. Don't worry. We're here for you guys.
Man, rap needed this.
We really did. We really, really did.
Oh.
What you need?
I need to drink and dance.
Okay. All right. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to another episode of the Top Hill Podcast. This is your boy, Mr. Top Hill Pod, a.k.a. E-Money Boss.
And my name is Carmen.
And we'll see you guys next week. We out. Peace.
3:10.
Shout out to Thug, shout out to Scrapper. We'll get to you guys next week. I got a screenshot of y'all Joan right now.
She's driving me down to our beat again. She popping around, got her freaking again. She's driving me down to our beat again. She's driving it down. Right after I smash, I just wanna do this book again. After she climax, I just wanna do this book again. Right after I smack, I just wanna do this book again.
If you don't like this album, it's something wrong with you. I ain't gonna be honest with you.
Again, again, again.
We out.